Now start next article. Minimum detectable signal. If the echo signal has minimum power, detecting that the signal may be a signal by the radar is known as the minimum detectable signal. Once again, if the echo signal has minimum power, detecting that signal by the radar is known as the minimum detectable signal. This means radar cannot detect the echo signal if the signal having less power than that of the minimum power. In general, radar receives the echo signal in addition with noise. If the threshold value is used for the detecting the presence of the target from the received signal, then that detect is called the threshold detection. We have to select proper threshold value based on the strength of the signal to be detected. A high threshold value should be chosen when the strength of the signal to be detected is high so that it will be eliminate the unwanted noise signals present in it. Similarly, a low threshold value should be chosen when the strength of the signal be the detected is low. The following figure illustration is given. There one side is voltage, then threshold value, and this is the RMS value of the noise with time. A typical waveform of the radar receiver is shown in above figure. The x-axis and y-axis represent time and voltage respectively. The RMS value of noise and threshold values are indicated with dotted lines in the above figure. We have considered three points A, B, C in the above figure for identify the valid detection and missing detections. The value of the signal at point A is greater than that the value threshold. Hence, it is a valid detection. Now, so in this diagram, this is the A point. In this case, the value of this peak is higher than the threshold value. Hence, this point is the valid detection. The value of signal at point B is equal to threshold and hence is the valid detection. Again, point B, its value is equal to threshold value. So, it is again valid point. Even though the value of the signal at point C is closer to the threshold value, it is a missing detection because the value of the signal at point C is less than the threshold value. In this case, C1, okay? So, the points A and B are the valid detection, whereas the point C is missing detection. Next is the receiver noise. If the receiver generates a noise component into the signal, which is received at the receiver, then that kind of noise is known as the receiver noise. The receiver noise is an unwanted component. We should try to eliminate it with some precautions. However, there exists one kind of noise that is known as the thermal noise. It occurs due to the thermal motion of the conduction electrons. Mathematically, we can write thermal noise power Ni is equal to K T0 Bn, where K is the Boltzmann constant and is equal to 1.38 10 to the minus 23 joule per degree. T0 is the absolute temperature and is equal to 290 degree Kelvin. Bn is the receiver bandwidth. Next is figure of merit. The figure of merit F is nothing but the ratio of input SNR and output SNR. Mathematically, this can be expressed as F is equal to SNR upon SNR0. And simplification, we will get Si is equal to Fni as 0 and 0. By substituting the value of Ni, K is T0 Bn in above equation, we will get, and on final simplification, we will get the value of R maximum is equal to पी टी सिग्मा जी ए ई अपॉन 4π² के एफ टी ज़ीरो बी एन एस एन एस ज़ीरो बाई एस एन ज़ीरो मिनिमम टू द पावर 1/4. From the above equation, we can conclude that the following condition should be considered in order to get the range of the radar as maximum. Peak power transmitted by the radar, PT, should be very high. Gain of the transmitting antenna, G, should be high. Radar cross-section of the target sigma should be high. Effective aperture of the receiving antenna AE should be high. Figure of merit F should be low. Receiver bandwidth BN should be low. Tomorrow we will start the new topic.